Hey, it's Matt and Lizzie in the morning. And did you realize that people can listen to us anytime they want?
They can?
Nonstop if they wanted to.
No.
Yeah, it's Matt and Lizzie on demand. And it starts right now.
92
Moose, Central Maine's number one hit music station. The last thing Lizzie said to me before we turned the microphones on was, this is a great daily awe. This is a great daily awe, get ready.
This is a great daily awe, get ready. And I said it really fast.
Yeah, because we were about to go on. So I have no idea.
Okay, let me put my glasses on. I need my glasses for this one.
I have no idea what we're about to hear, but I am a little excited. Jim, kick it.
Thank you. Okay, we're jumping off right away. Neighbors, we love them. We hate them. But we all have them. Oh, unless God, you live in the middle of the woods.
That's a conversation for another
okay,
day.
And we can talk about that. Ooh, make a little note. Boop, boop. I'm fortunate enough, though, to tell the world how lucky I am to have a neighbor named Mo. Now, let me give you the scoop on Mo. He's been living in the house across the street for a very, very long time. It's almost like the neighborhood is his lighthouse and he's the keeper. So he lets us know if the storms are coming or if there's pirates. That's the best type of thing. He's that guy. He's big and he's strong and he's tall. Mo's a bit up there in age. He loves coming outside when we're outside with our son doing, he sits and chats. He tells us that there's a new bird nest in his yard.
Does he live alone?
He lives alone.
And when you say up there in age, are we talking 60s? Are we talking maybe
80s? No, north of 80s.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right.
When we have fires, he ensures that we have enough wood and he always keeps an eye out for our little family. He's very special to us.
You're his purpose.
Right. Recently, Mo got very sick and we hadn't seen him outside. Don't worry. It's a happy ending.
Okay.
The hot days brought our little family outside for our picnics and our gardening and baseball games, but no Mo. One day I was mowing the lawn recently and heard, young lady, that's what he says to me. I don't think he even remembers my name, but he calls me young
lady.
Well,
compared to him, you are young.
Thank you. I turned and saw Mo. I ran over thrilled to see him because at this point it had been weeks, maybe actually over a month.
You didn't think maybe you should go knock on the door.
Okay. We did. We left a note and we left our phone number and we did see people going in and out. Oh, we did the well check.
Okay, good. Because I'm waiting 3 or 4
yes,
weeks. That's,
no. He was alive. We just knew he was struggling. So, and Mo's not fragile. Like I said, he's a strong Mainer. So it saddened me to hear that he's having some serious health issues. But despite telling me that, he had a simple request. He has these big, beautiful, wild blueberry bushes in his backyard.
That's awesome.
Because of his health problems, he can't collect them this year. It's one of his most favorite things to do besides watching his huge rose bush bloom. It's gorgeous. He told me about that and he let me know I could pick some if I wanted. So yesterday, Bentley and I walked over with Janelle and we were overwhelmed by endless, deep, ripe, gorgeous blueberries we picked until our fingers were purple, buckets full. We went home. I taught Bentley how to remove the stems, wash it, check for worms. And then he excitedly volunteered, I want to bring them to Mo. So the smile on Mo's face, oh my God, he was so grateful. But then he let us know he was welding up a little bit. He said that he's been tending to those bushes since his kids were little and it was their task every year and they would happily all do it together as a family. Okay. Now, not many people visit Mo. Mostly his medical people and then I think his son comes every now and then. People are busy, I get it. But he is lonely. As we walked away from Mo's house, Bentley looked up at me and said, Mama, he was that happy about blueberries? And I said, yes, Bentley, he was that happy.
It wasn't the blueberries, Bentley.
It wasn't the blueberries, Bentley. It's all about the simple things in life. And when your bones get tired and your hands don't work the same way, you get sad. The smallest thing, like picking from the blueberry bush that you've watched grow since your babies were young, becomes the most precious happiness. I said, life is very short, Bentley. Stay in the moment. Be grateful for the little things because one day, like Mo, you'll look back and see them as the big things.
In a weird way, this kind of reminds me of that Tom Hanks film, A Man Named Otto, a little bit.
Yeah, a bit. It has that to it. But it's really important to remember that some people's little things are going to, like us, we're going to get older. And the little things we used to enjoy, like gardening with Bentley and playing baseball and watching your kids play with a dog, those are the biggest things. Don't take anything for granted. And there you go, my darlings. That's your daily off.
And going to be shifting gears here just a little bit this morning. Yesterday, when we got off the air, we had Kachira Wyman join us.
Yes.
Whose twin boys, passed away at 17 and 18 months.
Loxley and Torben
from a very rare immunodeficiency. which was sort of discovered after their vaccines, MMR and chickenpox and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Now, there's a benefit that's going to be going on to help the family. This benefit was actually planned while the boys were still here. Sadly, they are not, but the benefit continues on because those costs, the associated medical costs, those are all still there. It just such a tragedy for any parent to have to ever go through this. And
unnatural, to say the least.
100%. And we're going to play that interview back for you right now. Keshira Wyman and her twin boys, Torben and Loxley. Yeah, we're pleased to be joined by Keshira Wyman this morning. We're going to be talking about a benefit that is coming up. First, we want to talk about why this benefit is coming up. Your 17-month-old twins, Loxley and Torben, both have sadly passed away due to something very rare. And I'd like to speak on that just a little bit, if we could. If you could give us just a little background on Loxley and Torben and what sort of led to all of this unfolding.
Well, ever since they were born, they constantly had a cold. Mm-hmm. I always constantly brought them in. I'm like, something's wrong. Yeah. Nothing was ever wrong. They went in 15 months for their chickenpox and MMR vaccine.
Right.
And within a month's time, they were showing signs of measles and chickenpox primarily. I dealt with it home for a week. Yeah. And then I brought them in because Torben was having really bad pain in his hip. He ended up having an infection in his muscles in his leg where he couldn't move it. Portland, Barbara Bush took care of that. And then just
Like a few months old.
They were 15 months.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, 15 months. That's when you start getting the varicella is what they call it.
So this progressed rapidly.
Yeah.
Yes.
This progressed very rapidly.
Yes. As soon as they got the vaccine, it was within a week.
And I'm just reading a little bit about this. It's a rare immunodeficiency, but it's a NIC, N-I-C deficiency. What is that?
Yeah. So they're T and B cells. The T does the antibodies.
Yeah.
And then the B is your body learns the virus to get rid of it.
Right.
And the NK cells, which are the natural killer cells, all of those weren't working properly.
So their bodies couldn't learn how to fight it.
Like that's how vaccines work.
Right, huh. Right.
And the chickenpox vaccine is a live virus vaccinations weekend, but where we just had the flu maybe a month prior to the vaccine, and I think it suppressed it down so much when they got the vaccine. It just progressed, and it's a neuro one, so it was just something so big that their immune system that they had couldn't handle the chicken pox whatsoever.
And care ended up being transferred to Boston Children's.
Yes, and they're great.
And you ended up losing both boys within what?
Within a month.
Yeah.
2 days shy of a month.
So Torben was 17 months and Loxley was 18 months.
Yeah.
And obviously, I think I speak for everybody listening to this show. We are so sorry.
Thank you.
For your loss. What an incredible heartbreak.
Well, we're speaking about this we're laying out the facts right now. But how are you still here right now, honey?
My other kids.
Yeah.
My other kids.
A 7-year-old and a 3-year-old, correct?
Yes. Yeah.
And the benefit's still happening.
It is.
Because, you know, even though this has resulted in a tragic ending, those funds are still needed. We were talking about, you know, a headstone for them.
So raising awareness for what this is to help other, parents.
Could have been caught at birth.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, this is something they can blood test for?
They do that with every single baby that is born. They prick their heel and they put it on the piece of paper. Yeah.
The heel prick.
It's for the rare diseases.
Okay.
But this is so rare, it's just not one that's picked up. Boston Children has only ever seen one other case.
Wow.
Wow.
So they knew kind of what to do, but all the other complications that they got with, they couldn't get rid of to take care of.
Yeah, because you were talking about a potential marrow transplant and all this other stuff, but you got to be healthy to get the transplant, which your twins never were.
Right.
Yeah.
No, they weren't. And we had hopes for Loxley. He had a 10 out of 10 match. But if he had come out of it, his lungs may have been so damaged that he couldn't go through chemo.
Right.
And so where would we be after
that? At
that
point, yeah. Exactly.
He would have gotten sick again.
Right.
Over something.
Back at square one kind of thing with that. Now, the benefit is happening on Saturday, July 27th at Monmouth Fish and Game. That's right on Route 202 in Monmouth.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Tell us a little bit about the benefit, what people can expect to see there, and if people want to provide donations for the benefit, can they still do that?
Yes, of course. You'll see on the flyer, there's Venmo and PayPal, and I believe there's somebody to contact if you have any donations that you would like. If you have anything for raffle tickets, we've got quite a bit. We've got whitewater rafting. I don't quite remember where it was. It was just brought to my attention last night.
Awesome.
But we
This list is great. There's all kinds of good stuff on that.
Everybody wants to help. Expecting this much, and apparently we know a lot more people than we realize.
Yeah. Well, even the people that you don't know. I mean, this is not a natural thing that's supposed to happen. A mother is not is supposed to lose her children. So that's when we all want to throw everything at you that we can, including our love. And that's why that list is so big.
Yes.
Everything from Longfellow's, Ted's Trackside, Wiscasset Speedway, Moose Mountain, that new mini golf place in Richmond that everyone wants to try out. That's on the list. Jack Trapps is here. There's different golf courses. Camping is on here. So plenty of things. The Senator, get a massage. You know, hopefully this reaches enough people to make this a giant success.
Right.
In what would otherwise be just such a tragedy. Is there a website? Is there a GoFundMe? Is there a Facebook page? Where can we send our audience to continue to get updates on this?
Right. There is a Facebook page for the event. I also have a GoFundMe.
Yep.
That has reached its, I don't know if you can donate more after you've reached your limit.
You can, I believe, yes. Okay. Yes. Oh, yeah.
So please then, I believe it's all on there, on the flyer,
we'll get this out on our Facebook, because the link is just a link with numbers. So we'll make it a little bit easier. We'll post
the QR codes as well
on our Facebook and on our social so you guys know where to go. But the benefit, like we said, Monmouth Fishing Game, July 27th from 11 to 3 to help support Kachira and make this something that can raise some more awareness and help with financial burden that it's caused on you and your family.
And again, right on Route 202 in Monmouth, super easy to find.
Yes.
Hamburgers and hot dogs and chips.
We're all hugging you.
Chips.
The Moose Nation supports you, and we love you, darling, and thank you for coming in.
Thank you so much for helping me bring awareness to this.
We got you.
92 Moose.
What is...
Y'all ready? 90 Fish.
Prince UA.